एम आई ऑडिबल? हेलो, हेलो, एम आई ऑडिबल? ओके, नाउ लेट्स स्टार्ट विथ अवर टूडेज टॉपिक रिलेटेड टू गोम्स. ओके, ऑलरेडी वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट फिट्स लॉ. ओके, माई स्क्रीन इज विजिबल? माई स्क्रीन इज विजिबल? ओके, सो फिट्स लॉ, सो अकॉर्डिंग टू फिट्स लॉ, स्पीड एंड एक्यूरेसी ऑफ मूवमेंट्स आर इंपॉर्टेंट कंसिडरेशन इन द डिजाइन ऑफ इंटरेक्टिव सिस्टम्स एंड प्राइमरीली इन टर्म्स ऑफ द टाइम टेकन टू मूव टू ए पर्टिकुलर टारगेट ऑन ए स्क्रीन. एंड द टारगेट मे बी ए बटन, ए मेन्यू आइटम और एन आइकन और अदर ऑप्शंस on the screen as well as on software or hardware. Okay, and the time taken to hit the target is a function of the size of target and distance that has to be moved. So this is a for Fitts law. Okay, so next is our evaluation through expert analysis. Okay, so already we have discussed about this evaluation through expert analysis, in which first is cognitive walkthrough, an attempt to introduce psychological theory into the informal and subjective walkthrough technique. Okay, already we have discussed in I think second lecture. Okay, then second is heuristic evaluation, a guideline or general principle or rule of thumb that can guide a design decision or be used to critique a decision that has already been made. Okay, then next, third is model based evaluation. So today's topic is related to our GOMS, which is model based evaluation. Okay, so in model based evaluation, the use of models, certain cognitive and design models, provide a means of combining design specifications. Okay, and evolution into the same framework. Okay, so there are some cognitive or design models which are used in a specific framework to describe some specification and evolution for that model. Okay, and for example, here GOMS, goals, operator, methods and selection in field form. Okay, so G for goals, O for operators, M for methods, and S for selection. So GOMS model predict user performance with a particular interface and can be used to filter particular design options. Okay, and similarly, low level modeling techniques such as the keystroke level, which we will study this KLM model in next lecture. So lower level modeling techniques uses like keystroke level model provides prediction of the time users will take to perform low level physical tasks. So this GOMS is based on this Fitts law. Okay, we have to capture the movement, but we have to also define some descriptive model. Okay, for this we use model based evaluation, and in which we have GOMS. Okay, then goal and task hierarchies. Many models make use of a model of mental processing in which the user achieves goals by solving sub goals into a divide and conquer fashion. So we have to divide goals into sub goals, and then sub goals is also divided into other sub goals. So it makes a tree like structure, or it can be called as divide and conquer fashion. So there are goals is divided into various goals, and then we can analyze and provide some solution related to that problem or model. Okay, so we will consider two models, GOMS and CCT. So today we will only discuss about GOMS, and in next lecture, or I think and next to next, we will study about CCT. Okay, depends upon our syllabus. Okay, but it is also useful. CCT is also useful. Okay, so for example, here we want to produce a report on sales of introductory SCI textbook. So here is an example related to our tech resource SCI book. Okay, so to achieve this goal, we divide it into several sub goals, or we can say gathering the data together, producing the tables, histograms, and writing the descriptive material. So our main goal is a report on sales of introductory SCI textbook, and we have to identify such other details like gathering the data and producing the tables. Okay, so concentrating on the data, complete this into further sub goals. Okay, for data gathering we can divide, or we can make sub goals like, first find the names of all introductory SCI textbooks, and then search the book sales database for these books. Okay, so similarly each of the other sub goals is divided up to into further sub goals, and until some level of detail is found at which we decide to stop. Okay, there is a limit for dividing sub goals, so if there is some limitations, then we have to stop there. Okay, according to goal, then we thus and end up with a hierarchy of goals and sub goals, and there are various issues arises as one attempts, such as analysis of computer use. Okay, so here is the pseudocode type, you can say structure, okay, or you can say algorithm structure for this goals. Our goals is a report on sales of introductory. First produce report, okay, then gather data. Again it is divided into two parts, okay, to find book names, and then second is search database. So again find books is again divided into two, do keyword search of name database, okay, and again it is divided into sub goals. Okay, so we will not discuss about these sub goals. Okay, and second is sift through names and abstract by hand. Again they are divided into sub goals. Now at last there is a again a other goal, sub goals is layout tables and histograms. Okay, so we have a main goal is produce a report, then there is a sub goal gather data, then layout tables and histogram, then third is write description. Again these are divided into sub goals. Okay, so as well this first sub goals, we can divide other goals sub goals into other sub goals. Okay, so again layout and tables and histograms are also divided into sub goals, and write descriptions is also divided into sub goals. So it makes a structure. Okay, divide and conquer fashion structure. So we will identify and solve our goals or problems. Okay, so there are various issues related to GOMS and CCT. Okay, so there are some questions like where do we stop. Okay, where do we stop. Okay, there are a number of levels here, so we have to find out the stop level. Okay, then we can go on decomposing tasks until we get down to the individual hand or eye movement of the user. Okay, depends upon the search, or depends upon the book, SCI book. Okay, and depends upon the sub goals also. So, or we can stop at more abstract level. Okay, we will go in deep to find the proper detail about that task or goal. Okay, and second question is, where do we start? Okay, how, where is the starting point of our search or our report making. Okay, so in a similar way we can start our analysis at different points in the hierarchy of goals. So we can start from we have started from here. Okay, but in case of these sub goals we have to start from here. Okay, so again there are points will be changed according to sub goals and goals. Again these two questions are issue of granularity. Okay, we have to identify the details, we have to identify the more or deep details about you can say levels or sub goals and goals, and both of the method described below leave this to some extent in hands of the designer. So it provide a abstract view of model to designer. Okay, so different design issues demand different level of analysis. It is important. Okay, then both methods operate at a relatively low level. Neither would attempt to start with such an abstract goals as produce a report, and which will involve real creativity and difficult problem solving. Okay, there is the you can say designer have some capability like creativity and problem solving technique. Okay, then they confine themselves to more routine learned behavior. Okay, and most abstract task is referred to as the unit task. Okay, again, this task can be divided into different you can say designers, and then designers will identify their goals, and they will divide them into sub goals. Again, the unit task does not require any problem solving skills on the part of the user. Okay, and the demand quite sophisticated problem solving skills on the part of the designer to determine them. Okay, the final decision is based on the designer, how they solve the goals or problems according to their creativity and problem solving technique. Again, there are some issues. So first is, what do we do when there are several ways of solving a problem? Okay, there is a problem and there are several methods or several ways to solve the problem. There may be some time consuming solution, or there are short solutions. Okay, and there are interactive solutions also. And if the solutions are two sub goals interact, okay, there are two sub goals interact, then what will be the solution if the two sub goals are interacted with each other? Okay, then users will often have more than one way to achieve a goal. Okay, there are more than one way. Okay, and there must be some way of representing how they select between competing solution. If there are two designers and they are trying to find out some solution, there is the possibility that some two designs are different, but one is more accurate than other. Okay, then another important issues has to do with the treatment of error. Okay, there are some errors also in solving the problems. Okay, so users are not perfect. Okay, the goal hierarchies may show how to how the perfect users would achieve a goal, and it is difficult to say that users may have solved that problem, or a designer can solve that problem. Okay, and the prediction of error behavior is poor amongst these hierarchical modeling techniques like CCT. Okay, so CCT can CCT can provide or represents error behavior also, but in Coombs we cannot represent errors behavior. Okay, so both techniques are important, Coombs and CCT. Now Coombs, so we will today discuss only these four parts. Okay, goals, operator and methods, and selection. So Coombs model of Cord, Maron and Novel. Okay, so it is acronym for goals, operator, methods and selection. These are the developer of this Coombs models, and we can divide, or we can say Coombs description consists of these four elements, like first goals, second operator, then method, then selection. And these are in serial fashion. Okay, we have to identify first goal, then there are some operators, then find some methods, and then we have to select some proper solution. Okay, so these are the user goals, like describing what the user wants to achieve. Okay, mostly because system should be user friendly, so most important goal is describe what the user wants to achieve. And in Coombs, the goals are taken to represent a memory point for the user. Okay, from starting to end, and from which he can evaluate what should be done, and to which he may return should any errors occur. Okay, so Coombs provides some solutions to remember, user can remember some points or levels, so he can return back to if there is an error. So first is okay. Second is operator, because we already studied goals. Okay, we have to define goals, and we have to identify the memory point, you can say, as labels to backward for according to errors. Then operator. Second is operator. These are the lowest level of analysis. Okay, operators are the lowest level of analysis. They are the basic actions that the user must perform in order to use the system. Okay, so there is an example like press the X key. Okay, that X key can affect the system, and this can be depend on the user's mental state. Okay, if he wants to read the dialog box, or he wants to do some other tasks, so he can go for short keys, or he can use mouse-like buttons. Okay, so here is the example related to this. And there is still a degree of flexibility about the granularity of operators. Okay, so details should be given to users, so the user can use that operator or that button or that menu or that options easily. And we may take the commands level like issue the select command. Okay, there should be a message or other options, so user can understand what is the next level or what is the next task to perform easily. Okay, and be more primitive, like move mouse to menu bar. Okay, or press center mouse button. So these are the steps for the users according to goals and sub goals. Then methods. Third is method. So there are several ways in which a goal can be split into sub goals. And in a certain window, manager is currently selected window can be closed to an icon. Okay, so here is an example of window manager. So we have to close that window manager. Okay, there is a window, and we have to close that. So already we know that we have a cross, red cross here, so we can cross that window. But in earlier systems, there is no option for close. So there is a close button will be available on the software. So by selecting the close option from the pop-up menu, okay, so we can like here I can okay, there is no close button, but quit button. Okay, and then by hitting the next option is by hitting the L7 function key. Okay, there should be a system like where the systems have options like L7, but in our keyboard there is no button related to L7. Only we have a function keys. Okay, so there are specific keys provided, or there are specific close options provided to close a window manager. Okay, there is no related to Microsoft Windows. Okay, there are various software, they provide different options for closing the window. And in GNOME, these two goals decompositions are referred to as methods. Okay, so there are first method is close method, and second is L7 method. So we will discuss here these two methods. Okay, in short, so here dots are used to indicate the hierarchical level of goals. So again, these dots provide sub goals of goal sub goals or goals. Okay, so primary goal is iconize window. Okay, so sub goals is use close method or use L7 method. So in close method, there are some steps. Okay, first move mouse to Windows Reader, then second step pop up menu, then third step click over close option. Okay, like here I will go to here, then I will choose a quit or other options. Okay, so these are fixed steps. You cannot directly go to close option. Okay, then there is second goal sub goals use L7 method. Okay, there you can press L7 key if available on keyboard, so the window will be closed. And final and fourth technique is selection. Okay, so according to previous here, okay, these are two methods. हेलो, एम आई ऑडिबल? हेलो, एम आई ऑडिबल? आई विल एक्टिवेट द फॉर्म ऑफ अटेंडेंस ऑलरेडी गिवन टू इन क्लासरूम, ओके, गूगल क्लासरूम. सो यू कैन गो एंड देन यूज दैट लिंक. आई विल एक्टिवेट इट. आई एम एक्टिवेटेड दैट गूगल फॉर्म, ओके, फॉर अटेंडेंस पर्पज. आई हैव एक्टिवेटेड. तो बैक टू अवर स्लाइड, ओके. तो लास्ट पॉइंट इज सिलेक्शन. तो अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस, अकॉर्डिंग टू अवर टू मेथड्स, ओके, हियर, सो देयर इज द चॉइस ऑफ मेथड्स प्रॉब्लम इज अराइजेज. सो अकॉर्डिंग टू गोम्स, सो गोम्स गिव्स रैंडम चॉइसेस, ओके, एंड बट अटेम्प्ट्स टू प्रिडिक्ट विच मेथड विल बी यूज डिपेंड्स अपॉन द यूजर, ओके, एंड द यूजर हैव द मोर पावर और मोर ऑथराइजेशन टू चूज दैट मेथड, ओके, एंड डिपेंड्स अपॉन द यूजर. सो ऑलरेडी वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट ह्यूमन. ह्यूमन्स हैव डिफरेंट कैपेबिलिटीज अकॉर्डिंग टू देयर नॉलेज एंड इंफॉर्मेशन. सो ह्यूमन कैन इंटरेक्ट विद देयर मैकेनिकल पार्ट्स, बॉडी पार्ट्स, ओके, देयर सेंसर्स, टच, ओके, हियरिंग, अकॉर्डिंग टू हियरिंग, एंड देन अकॉर्डिंग टू आई, ओके. सो हियर इज एग्जाम्पल, लाइक ए यूजर सैम नेवर यूज द L7 मेथड, ओके, एक्सेप्ट फॉर वन गेम, ओके. सो ब्लॉक्स, देयर इज अ गेम रिलेटेड टू ब्लॉक्स वेयर द माउस नीड टू बी यूज इन द गेम अंटिल द वेरी मोमेंट द की इज प्रेस्ड, ओके. यू हैव टू यूज माउस अकॉर्डिंग टू दैट गेम, ओके. सो हियर सैम यूज L7 मेथड्स इन केस ऑफ गेम, ओके, एंड गोम्स कैप्चर दिस इन अ सिलेक्शन रूल फॉर सेम. सो ही विल नॉट यूज ऑलवेज L7 मेथड, बट इन केस यूजर यूज सेम यूज फर्स्ट रूल, लाइक यूज द क्लोज मेथड अनलेस अनदर रूल अप्लाइज, ओके. सो हियर इज द रूल वन, यूज द क्लोज मेथड अनलेस अनदर रूल्स अप्लाई. सो आफ्टर कंप्लीटिंग द गेम्स सेम कैन बी यूज L7 मेथड, ओके. सो सेकेंड रूल अप्लाईज हियर, इफ द एप्लीकेशन इज ब्लॉक यूज द L7 मेथड, ओके. तो दीज आर द फोर गोल्स गोम्स रिलेटेड, यू कैन से एलिमेंट्स, ओके, गोल्स, ऑपरेटर एंड मेथड एंड सिलेक्शन. नाउ वी विल गो अबाउट परफॉर्मेंस एंड यूज ऑफ दिस गोम्स टेक्निक. तो देयर इज परफॉर्मेंस एंड यूज. तो एनालिसिस ऑफ द गोम्स गोल स्ट्रक्चर कैन यील्ड मेजर ऑफ परफॉर्मेंस, लाइक स्टैकिंग डेप्थ ऑफ ए गोल स्ट्रक्चर कैन बी यूज टू एस्टिमेट शॉर्ट टर्म मेमोरी रिक्वायरमेंट, एंड द मॉडल ऑफ यूजर्स मेंटल प्रोसेसिंग इम्प्लाइड बाय that models or goals, okay, and the selection rules can be tested for accuracy against user traces and change in response to discrepancies, okay. And in early experiments in this technique, the inventors were able to achieve on average of 90% correct prediction rate of user commands. How users select the method, how user behave according to the response, okay. So inventors have achieved 90% correct prediction rate for this Gooms technique. And a very simple method of predicting times was able to predict actual times with an error of 33%. Okay, so this is the actual performance of this Gooms model. And the original Gooms model has served as the basis for much of the cognitive modeling research in SCI. So we can use this Gooms model in our cognitive modeling research, and it was good for describing how experts perform routine tasks, okay, then coupled with physical devices modeled and can be used to predict the performance of these users in terms of execution times according to these physical devices. And it was never intended to provide the kind of information about the user knowledge. So Gooms did not provide the user's knowledge, or you can say error report also, okay. CCT technique will provide that detail about errors, and then user knowledge that could be compared across different tasks in order to predict things like training or transfer time. So So this depends upon the Fitts law. Okay, so again we can combine this Gomes and Fitts law to get the more detail about the user experience and increase the performance according to Gomes model. So that's all about this Gomes model. Then we will in next we will study about KLM, okay, keystroke method, keystroke model. Okay, so today the class is complete here. Okay, now you can fill this form. Okay, or maybe you already filled this form. Any issue related to today's topic? You can study this topic from that NPTEL site, but there is no more details about Gomes there. Okay, in short they provided some details, so I will show the site also here. This is the site here, NPTEL. Okay, so they have not provided more details about these models. Okay, they only provided some already we have discussed some details. Okay, so they provided some short details here. Okay, again there is a CTA technique also here. Okay, cognitive task analysis. So there are three techniques like Gomes, CCT and CTA. Okay, and CCT is our cognitive, sorry, okay, I will show you. CCT is, okay, CCT is cognitive complexity theory. Okay, so we will discuss later on about this technique. Okay, so you can go and read about this models, Gomes model in short from this site, and then you can go for also for KLM model here. Okay, keystroke level model, keystroke level model for Gomes. So any issue, then send me messages on Google Classroom. Okay, so today's class over here. You can leave one by one.